what drives me is the excitement and mystery of knowing every single day that when I get up that day, there's a chance that I'll discover something that could make a huge impact on the world. My name is Houra Merrikh, and I'm an assistant professor in the microbiology department at the University of Washington in Seattle. I was born in Tehran. My family left Iran during the war. The idea was to move to the United States. We were going to spend 6 months in Turkey while the paperwork came together. Actually, it took 13 years. I ended up having to move to the United States on my own. I was 16. The key thing that got me through the immigration process and the hardships over the years is big picture, being able to keep the big picture in mind all the time. And that, of course, applies to my work now. There are two essential processes to life. The genome has to be duplicated, that's DNA replication, and the genes have to get expressed, and that's the process of transcription. DNA replication and transcription both use the genetic material as a template. And so that creates a conflict. Conflicts are important to study because the evolution of the genome is actually highly influenced by replication-transcription conflicts. Our discovery of accelerated evolution is really putting forth a phenomenon that conflicts reveal to us. It's been thought for a long time that under conditions where adaptation is demanded, cells can increase mutation rates globally. What our discovery showed was that actually that doesn't have to be the case. Our work put forth a model for temporally and spatially regulated evolution. We figured out the underlying mechanisms that increase mutation rates in a gene-specific manner and actually showed that evolution can happen in a targeted way in specific genes. I would like to take what we've learned and get at underlying mechanisms that lead to disease and cancer and antibiotic resistance. I hope to be somebody that sets an example and facilitates the system in a way that people that have gone through hardships can bring their abilities to science.